If you are looking for a drone that can film yourself during sports, action and fast-paced activities in general, then watch this video carefully, because today I'm answering the following three questions. How good is the Hover Air X1 Pro Max? Is it really suitable for filming sports and action? And of course, how does it work? And how do you operate it? I've already tested the DJI Neo and the Flip extensively, and you can find a detailed tutorial on the two selfie drones from DJI on my channel. So I wanted to know how good the drones from Hover Air are that DJI wanted to compete with the Neo and the Flip. The X1 Pro Max is available in different versions. In addition to the drone alone, there is also a basic combo or a cycling combo. I have the skiing combo here. In addition to the X1 Pro Max, it comes with two thermal batteries for cold temperatures and the power case, in which you can not only transport the drone, but also charge it. The power case is also suitable for low temperatures and basically works like a case for AirPods. And of course, there is also the ingenious beacon. I know this thing caused some problems first, but now it works perfectly. I'll show you what you can do with it a little later. For me, one of the great strengths of the X1 Pro Max and of course the other versions of the X1 is its portability. You can fold it up quickly and easily, and it then fits in any jacket pocket. Basically, as you can see, even in a trouser pocket. In addition to the camera, the X1 Pro Max also has sensors on the underside and on the back. The sensor at the back is designed to prevent collisions when flying backwards. The charging port and the slot for a microSD card are located on the side. Incidentally, the X1 Pro Max comes with 64 GB of internal memory, which is very useful, as I always forget to insert an SD card into my drone. You can easily remove the battery by gripping both sides and pulling upwards. Operation is very simple, as the X1 Pro Max basically only has a single button on the top. A quick press and you see the battery indicator. A long press and you switch the drone on. As soon as the drone is switched on, it tells you the current flight mode. In my case, hover. You can change the flight mode with the arrows to the left and right. You can also see the settings for the respective flight mode here. For example, 9 meters. And high for the zoom out flight mode. If you press and hold the button to the right or left, the respective setting starts to flash and you can now change it. You confirm by pressing the button in the middle. And the icon at the top left is quite important. It stands for Omni-Terrain. All selfie drones have difficulties when the ground doesn't have clear textures, because they work with the sensor on the bottom. So they have difficulties flying over water, snow or in low light conditions. And this problem is solved by the Omni-Terrain system. So as soon as it is available, you will also be able to fly in these situations. And with that, we can actually already start flying the Pro Max. To do this, place it on the palm of your hand, make sure that the camera is facing in your direction, and press the button once briefly, and it will take off and start the set flight maneuver. A recording is also started automatically. You can recognize this by the fact that the LED light on the front lights up red continuously. If it flashes orange, for example, the subject has not been captured. Once the flight maneuver is complete, the Pro Max will hover in place. You take a step towards it, place your hand under the drone, and once it has detected your hand, it will land safely on it. As you've seen, it's all extremely simple. Unfold, switch on, select the flight mode, and take off with a simple press. You don't need a remote control or a smartphone for this. But you can, of course, also control the X1 Pro Max with your smartphone. And you should also install the Hover X1 app right at the start, if only to install the latest firmware. As soon as you have switched on the drone, tap on Activate Connect, and the drone will connect to the app. Under Settings, you can select the flight mode, and also change the settings for the individual flight modes. So it's time to take a closer look at the flight modes. If you use Hover, the Pro Max will simply hover in place and start recording. If tracking is activated, it will always turn in the direction of the subject. However, it will not fly after the subject. As already mentioned, the recording will start automatically, and you do not have to do this manually. Make sure that the red LED lights up. With zoom out, the drone flies backwards, and depending on the setting, either rises or even sinks. The rear collision detection is active. In the important follow mode, the X1 Pro Max flies behind you and follows you, and it can do this even at relatively high speeds. In good conditions, it can follow you at up to 42 km per hour, which would be 26 miles per hour, so quite fast. But it always follows you from behind, and you can set the flight altitude. In orbit mode, the drone flies a circle around the subject. you can set the altitude and radius here. Unfortunately, the maximum radius is 6 meters, which in my opinion is a little too small. In bird's eye mode, it flies straight up and films the subject from above and takes another shot as it descends. And now we come to the really cool modes. In dolly track mode, the X1 Pro Max films you from the front. It flies in front of you. And that works surprisingly well, whereby the drone of course can't know which direction you're going in. So you should move in a predictable manner. But as you can see, you can get some pretty cool shots with this mode. The rear collision sensors are also active here. But of course, this only works up to a certain speed. The side track mode is similar, only here the drone follows you from the side, whereby you should be aware that it has no collision sensors on the sides. And the ski mode is of course a kind of follow mode, whereby the movements and special circumstances of skiing have been taken into account. And as you can see, that also works pretty well. The cycling mode is one of my favorite modes. It is similar to the ski mode or the follow mode, but the tracking in particular adapts to the special requirements of biking. For example, you can set whether you are in an open environment without many obstacles, in which case the X1 Pro Max will sometimes cut the curves and take a shorter route. On the other hand, if you set narrow routes, the drone will try to follow your route exactly to avoid a collision. And I have to say, it works very well. The indoor follow mode is similar. Here too, the drone tries to follow your movements exactly, taking into account the tight surroundings and the many obstacles indoors. And of course, you can also control the X1 Pro Max manually with your smartphone. To do this, tap the icon at the bottom right. You start the drone as usual by pressing the button on the drone or by tapping on the takeoff icon in the app. You can then control it using the virtual joysticks. And you can also adjust the tilt angle of the camera here on the right. Please note that in manual mode, you have to start and stop each recording yourself, as the recording is not started automatically. In manual mode, when using the smartphone, the maximum distance is 500 meters, which is quite far for controlling with a smartphone. Okay, it's time to take a closer look at the image quality and the corresponding recording settings. You should know the following. The X1 Pro Max has a 1 over 1.3 inch sensor, so the image sensor is not that small. It's comparable to the sensor of the DJI Action 5 or the Insta360 Ace Pro 2. And I would also say that the image quality is comparable to that of a modern action camera. The images are super sharp, have beautiful color and look very detailed. And this is also due to the extremely high resolution sensor. Whether in the intelligent flight modes or in manual mode, you can adjust the recording settings here. And in this context, the X1 Pro Max has a particular strength. It can shoot in a resolution of up to 8K and at up to 30 frames per second. And recordings in 8K look extremely crisp. Although I have to say that my M1 iMac has its difficulties with the playback of the recordings. But I probably should have used a different codec. Up to 60 frames per second are available in normal video mode and in 4K. In addition to the normal video mode, there is also an HDR mode for playback on HDR capable screens. And very importantly, a slow motion mode, in which the X1 Pro Max can shoot in 4K at up to 120 frames per second. The recording is then saved directly in slow motion. And also very important, the hover cine mode. This is a 10-bit color profile for a better dynamic range and a very cinematic look. It's not a real lock profile for heavy color grading, but a profile that lets you achieve a cinematic look with simple editing steps. Hover also offers a lot for quick conversion. Overall, the image quality is very good in my opinion, and completely sufficient for this type of device. I don't think there's any real HDR processing in the background. Some people prefer that, but it can lead to overexposed highlights in certain situations. And with an aperture of 2.55, the X1 Pro Max is of course no low-light beast. But even here, the quality is perfectly acceptable. For the intended purpose, the image quality is definitely good and particularly rich in detail. And I haven't shown you my favorite accessory yet, the beacon. Perhaps the coolest remote control I've ever seen. When it comes to portability, this is what I imagine. And not this. But the beacon is more than just a remote control. It has an integrated touch display, which is small but gives you a preview of the image. So you can mount the beacon on your bike, for example, and always check whether the drone is still following you. You switch the beacon on here using the power button on the right. You can use the touch display to adjust the flight mode and recording settings. By pressing the right function button, you can immediately abort a risky flight maneuver and then switch to manual mode by pressing the left button and control the drone yourself. And there is also return to home function. Simply press the right function button for more than 2 seconds, and the drone will fly fly back to the registered home point. The beacon also improves tracking accuracy and extends the maximum flight distance to 1 km. Although manual flying with these small control elements is of course not optimal and only makes sense in exceptional cases. And that's what the two joysticks are for. If you only connect the right joystick, you can use it to ascend or descend, or to turn the drone. And if you press the trigger button on the back, you can fly forwards and backwards or to the right and left by moving the beacon. You can also connect the left joystick for a fully fledged remote control. Now you can fly the X1 Pro Max like any other drone. Yes, the display is still a little small, but there is a solution for that too. You clamp your smartphone into the bottom here and connect it to the right joystick using a cable. And now you have a fully fledged remote control with a large display. Yes, I know, the beacon caused a few difficulties at first, but it worked perfectly in my test, and I think it's really innovative. Is the X1 Pro Max the drone that action and sports fans have been waiting for? Finally filming yourself doing sports with a drone without an additional pilot? I would say yes and no. Of course, the X1 Pro Max cannot replace a conventional action camera, but it's a super useful additional tool, especially for solo creators like me. It works great for sports like running. It's also great for biking, and I'll often take it with me for that, especially because you're not constantly going at speeds of more than 40 km per hour when mountain biking, for example. Apart from downhill, of course. When skiing, you should know how the Pro Max behaves. Especially on a groomed slope, you will quickly reach the maximum tracking speed. You must therefore not go too fast. Even large curves are not always optimal, as you can see here. The drone could quickly lose the subject. And if the terrain changes quickly, yes, then that can happen to you. But, and this also has to be said, the drone crashed into the relatively hard slope at maximum speed, but was not damaged as a result. And now we come to perhaps the only real drawback of the X1 Pro Max. The price. The most basic version costs $699, but only with one battery, which allows a maximum flight time of 16 minutes. Personally, I would therefore go for the cycling combo. This comes with the ingenious beacon and two additional batteries, charging hub, handlebar mount, ND filter, and this high quality bag. So everything you need. There is a special discount for this bundle at the moment, but it still costs $1,089. You can find a link to the various offers in the video description. The X1 Pro Max is simply a cool device, and I'll be taking it with me a lot in the future, especially for sports and vlogging. And it's also important that there are competing products to DJI drones that stimulates the market, and it's an advantage for us consumers. We also don't know whether DJI drones will still be available to buy in the US next year. So what do you think? Would you like to see a direct comparison with the Neo or the Flip? Let me know what you think in the comments. There will of course be more videos about selfie drones. Give me a like as feedback if this video was interesting for you, and see you next time.